I've always also said that I thought if you thought you were the only guy who could win, you'd do it.
Well, you know, let's say all the guys that were running all came together and said, hey, we've decided we can't do it. You must do it. That's the one out of a million we're thinking about.
Joining me now on our rapid response panel, Brad Woodhouse, former Democratic Party communications director and also Ring of Fire radio host and America's attorney, Mike Papantonio. Gentlemen, you're smiling at this story. I am too. This is one of these bring it on moments. I couldn't get enough of it. What's your response, Brad? I mean, is there truth in the possibility that circumstances can change and could Mitt Romney resurrect the effort? What do you think?
Ed, let me be the first on your show to offer my endorsement of Mitt Romney's candidacy for president. Look, I don't know if he'll run. I do think that the circumstances you laid out are exactly the circumstances that he's referring to. Mitt Romney is a calculating guy. It wasn't an accident that he said circumstances may change. And actually, I think circumstances have changed. They have a field that is in trouble, that is weak, that is either under indictment or under investigation, or has offended some segment of the Tea Party. And those are the circumstances that might make a Mitt Romney run possible. And I say bring it on. I mean, no one better than Mitt Romney can exhibit what the differences are between Republican policies on the economy and Democrat policies on the economy.
Well, he sure doesn't pass up any opportunities to criticize the president.
Although that's absolutely right.
But we have to point out that since the 2012 election, we have gained in private sector job growth every single month. So this idea that the president doesn't know anything about the economy, certainly that doesn't match up with what Mitt Romney was telling the country. And how does he transform himself with a 47% comment, Pat?
Now, there's no way to change circumstances. This is a guy who squandered $433 million to lose the last time he ran. My take is that what we see is pride talking with the Mitster. He's a little bit of a tragic character, Ed. His father was a well-loved and respected political figure who had many dimensions. The Mitt, on the other hand, created a legacy for himself that leaves him with the image of a predatory Bain Capital corporate hitman who left a trail of suffering and pillage all along the way. If the ghost of Christmas, Ed, were to visit the Mitt, he'd remind Mitt of the tens of thousands of Americans who were laid off from their jobs because of Mitt's brutal vulture capitalism. He'd also be reminded that as a wildly rich Wall Streeter, he was worried more about mansions and jets, while the average American was worried about how to feed his family or how to send their children to college or how to pay 30% taxes while Mitt was paying 11%. So even as bad as the GOP clown car starts looking with criminal trials, criminal indictments, probability of more criminal indictments, Mitt is a two-time campaign loser who is beyond meaningful rehabilitation. So there are no circumstances that I see that this guy is going to be in a race.
Well, that's why Brad Woodhouse just endorsed him for all of what you just said. All right, now, but the folks who are having some legal issues and some political issues who we mentioned in the run-up to this piece, Brad, can they be rehabilitated in time to fix their reputations to make a successful run for the presidency?
Well, look, I think it's possible. But, you know, for example, in New Jersey, Chris Christie, who knows, maybe there won't be a smoking gun. Maybe he won't be indicted. But I don't believe all these investigations have gone on all this long without some legal action being taken against people around him. Scott Walker is in a very tight race. He may lose his race for governor in Wisconsin. And guess what? Ain't no way he's going to run for president after that. I will just say this, Ed. I hate to disagree with one of your guests. I do not believe that it's out of the realm of possibility that Mitt Romney will run for president again. And I think because of what you alluded to, he's got the ego for it.
Oh, yeah.
He'll believe that he's the only one that can win because of the problems these other folks are facing.
Would the Tea Party extremists go along with it? Would they be the roadblock, Pat?
Well, I don't think the Tea Party extremists have ever been in love with him. There's a bigger problem, though. If anything, the average family in America right now is feeling the effects of our 1% class division even worse than they did the first time Mitt ran. So you have a public even more suspect of corporate vultures who now control 40% of America's wealth. In the eyes of many of the 99%, it's hard to tell the difference between Bernie Madoff, Bank of America, and Mitt Romney. And so that's always going to be in his way, whether he runs or not. I would agree. I would love to see him run, but I don't believe it's ever going to happen.
We still have the 47% tape. We can pull that thing out. He's going to have to he's going to have to edit that thing or come up with a new line to fix the folks out there who need a little bit of help out there in the economy. Great to have you with us, Brad Woodhouse, Mike Papantonio. Appreciate your time.